Hello and welcome back to our Proactive Studios. Here today from Alkane Resources, it's Managing Director Nic Earner. Nic, welcome back to the studio.
Well, thanks, Alicia. It's great to be with you.
So, Nic, Alkane has just released the production metrics for the 2023 financial year. Looking at the Tomingley Gold Operations here, it produced just over 70,000 ounces over that 12-month period. What are some of the highlights?
Yeah, thanks, Alicia. We have indeed. I think reaching 70,000 ounces is a highlight in itself. When we first, you know, looked at the financial year, we had 60 to 65,000 ounces as our estimate. And so, you know, really solid performance, particularly with grade reconciliations, let that happen. As well as that, though, it's been a, you know, really big year, which, you know, we alluded to in the announcement. We've seen the Tomingley Extension Project approved in February. Obviously, a lot of work going to that from the New South Wales government. We've also seen the underground development decline, the exploration decline that we've had running from Tomingley to Roswell, which is part of that approval on the future of the mining area. We've seen that approved. We've seen that actually reach Roswell. And so that's fantastic. We're doing grade control there at present. And then, of course, you know, completely separately in the business, the Boda and Kaiser Resources, which is great.
Certainly has been a busy year for the team. Talk to me a little bit about the all-in sustaining cost estimates as well. I know you've only got preliminary data at this stage, but you believe those figures will also come in between the middle of your ranges.
Yeah, that's right. So, you know, we revised that guidance to get steadily lower in cost through the course of the year, finishing at a range of $1,550 to $1,750 Australian dollars, you know, Australian dollars. We expect to be in the middle of that, in the middle of that range, it looks like. To give people an explanation of why it is, we can't say that immediately because it will be in our quarterly later on in July. The main reason for that is that we do a lot of inventory calculations and we work out that, you know, the depreciation, amortization, all these other things that go into the overall sustaining cost. So, yeah, but around mid-range of guidance.
All right. So Tomingley has been in operation since 2014, but not to be forgotten is your Boda project as well. You had some drilling there recently. How is that progressing?
Yeah, well, since we last spoke with Proactive, we did release results at Boda 2 in particular, you know, some deep results. Look, pretty encouraging. You know, it looks like that we'll be able to extend the resource from Boda further down into Boda 2, which will be great. That resource estimate will be before the end of the year. And, of course, we're waiting on some results. We hit some pretty interesting mineralisation down there, some breccia zones and things like that that we expect, you know, in the next 4 weeks, we would expect to see those assays come in, so reported in and around that timeline. So yeah, the infill drilling program, the upgrading of the resources, it's all very exciting at Boda as well.
And Nic, of course, a new financial year means plenty more work to come at Tomingley and Boda. Can you give investors a couple of the highlights you see on the horizon?
Well, firstly at Boda, because we were just talking about that, but the highlights there are the upgrading of the Boda resource, the upgrading of the Kaiser resource. Both of those should get an indicated portion as well, increasing their estimation certainty, and as well as that, we'll wrap some very preliminary financials around for people to get a feel for where we think that this could go as a deposit for mining. So that's part one. Part two is just all systems go at Tomingley. We have, within this next financial year, a large part of like a paste plant development for underground, upgrade of a flotation circuit to increase recoveries within the Tomingley operation process plant itself. We'll be doing grade control drilling, which we're doing at the moment already on the underground Roswell deposits. Continue to extend the, you know, the mine as it is in under the existing deposit. So there's a lot of activity going on and all to set up that future that we want to see Tomingley go beyond 2030, increased production rates. Yeah, really looking forward to it.
Well, Alkane Resources Managing Director Nic Earner, I'm sure it won't be too long at all before we get you back in the studio to discuss these copper and gold interests. We're looking forward to our next chat very soon.
Thanks, Alicia.